This is a short version of the Huawei P50 release too long, don't watch video of my longer 30 minutes something video of the new P50 release. Here we can see the P50 and the P50 Pro that have been released right now. They will be coming out earliest next month and probably in Europe in September. We have a reduction in weight on the P50 Pro, as you can see, 195 grams, 8.5 millimeters. The thickness is also reduced. The size is a slightly bit larger with 6.6 inch. The battery is also a bit larger, and the same on the P50, 6.5 inch instead of 6.1, 4,100 milliampere hours battery, also reduced in terms of thickness, 7.9 millimeters, but a little bit heavier with 181 grams. We have a flat display on the P50. We have a slightly curved display on the P50 Pro. We have a special edition on the P50 and the P50 Pro. So the P50 comes in three colors. The P50 Pro comes in five with this one special, which allows you to glow when a new call arrives. As you can see it, it changes the color of the same phone when a new call arrives. A nice replacement for a notification LED. We have new optics in those. The P50 Pro, the more interesting one, has still the same 50 megapixel sensor with a 1 over 1.23 inch size sensor, 23 millimeters f1.8 OIS. We have a new brand new 13 megapixel sensor for ultra wide capturing, 13 millimeter f2.2, hopefully also larger sensor. I don't know yet. Before we had a 1 over 1.54 inch size sensor, which was very large. But we have also in addition now a return of the monochrome sensor, 40 megapixel monochrome sensor, 26 millimeter with f1.6, hopefully also a very large one, so we can get more crispy details out of every photo. Then the interesting part is the 64 megapixel 90 millimeter 3.5 tele sensor with an f3.5 aperture and OIS. Of course, this one together with the monochrome should lead to very good zoom capabilities, up to 200 times zoom. Of course, we know there's some digital zoom definitely involved because we have only 3.5 times zoom. And if you want to zoom 200 times up, it is a bit of software magic going on here. I will come to this later. First of all, take a look at the P50. Also the same sensor, 50 megapixel, same sensor size, but without OIS. We have also 13 megapixel ultra wide angle, but with a different lens, 60 millimeter f2.2 in this case, so a bit narrower than on the Pro model. We have also, and interestingly enough, a periscope zoom, but 5x zoom, 125 millimeters, 12 megapixels only. So this is the one that will give you, also OIS of course, give you up to 80 times zoom capabilities from 16 to 1350 millimeters. Of course, I would say up to 30 or 40 times should be okay. Everything above this, perhaps not. But we don't know yet because Huawei is using a new technology called XD Optics. This is the old way how optics work. So if you have a subject here, you have some optics in between, you will not retain the picture. So 50% will be lost here. And then you have the ISP that can get it up 20%. And then you end up with roughly 60% of the photo that you saw here, now here. And with the new XD optics that Huawei does, because they are building the optics, they know how the optics work, they can compensate for the optics better, a lot better, with chips and software algorithms. They can, with the XDR optics, get already the 63, so 25% up. After the 50% that comes after the optics, they can get up to 63%, so something that other manufacturers can get with the ISP only. And then on top of this, they can put on their XD Fusion Pro and ISP and some other algorithms for better colors and so on to retain 81% of the photo. Pretty awesome technology, if you ask me, at least on paper. We have to see how it will look like in real life pictures. This is the real life pictures that we can see here, but Huawei is comparing this here. You can see this is where my mouse is what they are zooming in. 10 times zoom looks pretty sharp in comparison to the iPhone 12 Pro Max, but the iPhone 12 Pro Max doesn't have such zoom capabilities anyway. Would be far more interesting to compare it with the S21 Ultra or even the Huawei P40 Pro Plus or Mate 40 Pro Plus that have a 5 times optical and 10 times even optical zoom. We have better nighttime photos, again with the monochrome sensor, and some algorithms that have been implemented to improve stuff. We have better gaming performance, we have better performance in terms of battery life, and we have those prices here for the P50 Pro. Those are Chinese yuan, so if you take this middle model with 8 GB and 256 GB, you are around 800, 850, 900-ish euros. And when you take a look at the processors, it will come with the Kirin 9000 first in China and then later with the Snapdragon 888. You can see the pre-orders start from the 30th of July and the shipment is the 12th of August in China. So I don't know how it will look like in Europe. It could be in Europe that we have to wait for the Snapdragon variant that will be available in September. Then we have the P50 model, which will only be available in September. I'm not sure if it will arrive in Europe. Maybe it will arrive in Europe. Maybe they will come at the same time in September. This one only comes with the Snapdragon 888, and the price is around 650 euros for the 8 GB, 256 GB model, which is in line what we had before, I think, in terms of P40 and P40 Pro. So I think they will not throw all of those on the European market. And then we have some accessories. We have a charging pad, a Qi charging pad for free devices, 15 watts only. We have a ring light case. We have another of those fancy cases. And we have a case, a stand that is also available. Here you can see the zoom capabilities up to 100 times they show here. Looks pretty awesome, but we have to compare it with other devices. And here you can see again the zoom capabilities of the various devices that are available here. With the monochrome sensor, it should be available with XT Fusion Pro to get 103% more light or more less noise in pictures. It's called Super Color Filter System, which allows you to, in this low light 0.5 lux pictures, to get very nice details out of the picture. And they have a new color correction mode or color filter engine that allows you to reproduce very good colors, as well as a new focusing system, which should work better than the competitors like iPhone 12 and S21 Ultra that didn't get the shot, or they were completely didn't get the shot, or they were blurry. Very interesting to see how this competes with the Sony system that also has very fast autofocusing. And then we have a special edition that can change the color on incoming call, which is pretty interesting. So instead of LED, we have the incoming call notification. This is pretty much my quick run through all the new P50 series changes. We don't know yet when it will arrive in Europe. I would expect it in September. Maybe only one model will arrive, not the P50 and P50 Pro. We will see. And what about the P50 Pro Plus? Will there be one? We don't know yet.